Next, protista. So, in that protista, involved in that unicellular eukaryotic organism. Unicellular eukaryotes involved in that protista. So, protista, so they are not having, they do not having that, okay, boundaries. They do not have boundaries. They do not have boundaries means, so some protists are prokaryotes. So they are relation to that prokaryote link. They are linked to that prokaryotes, algae, fungi, plants, and animalia. It means some plants are also belongs to protists. They are that plant protists. Okay, this plant protists are okay. So many that, and some are animal protists. Okay, so what are that protista that character? So in that protista, they are having that a definite nucleus. So it is presence of cell wall or absent of cell wall. In presence of cell wall means if they are belongs to the plant protists, so they are covered with cell wall. So if cell wall is absent, they are known as that animal protists. Well defined that, well defined cell organella. Next, they are involved in that frag, it means vegetative reproduction and asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction takes place by that spores or by the fission. Okay, sexual reproduction takes place by the formation of gametes and by that fission of gametes. Fission of gametes, right? So in this having that ATS type of ribosomes. Okay, so they are involved in the definite, they having a definite nucleus. So definite cell organella. Asexual reproduction takes place by the spores and fission, and sexual reproduction takes place by that gametes or formation of gametes or fission of gametes. So ATS type of ribosomes are present. Okay, so we will discuss about that in the protista. They having the different types. So what are that? First one is the diatoms. Second one is the dinoflagellate. Euglenoids. Slime molds, protozoans. In protozoans, amoeboid protozoans, flagellated protozoans, ciliated protozoans. After that, sporozoans. Sporozoans. Sporozoids. Okay? So these are the protozoans. So in this, In protista include the diatoms, dinoflagellate, euglenoids, slime molds and protozoans. Protozoans are, first one is amoeboid protozoan, second one is flagellated protozoan, third one ciliated protozoan, fourth one sporozoids or sporozoans. So in this, what is the first one? Diatoms. We will discuss about that diatoms. Diatoms are generally, so they are known as that golden algae. They are also known as that golden algae desmids. They are also known as the golden algae and desmids. Right? So diatoms are grown in fresh water or marine. Okay? So generally they are freely float on that water currents. That's why it is known as that phytoplankton. Phytoplankton means they are freely float on the water. Passively move on water currents. On water currents, they are known as that phytoplankton. So after that, this cell wall having that cell wall form two thin shells. It means two thin overlapping shells. Overlapping shells. Okay. Epitheca over hypotheca. It means above the shell is known as that epitheca. Below that is known as that hypotheca. Below that is known as that hypotheca. Both are fit as that sew box, just like that. So that is known as that epitheca. Second one is that hypotheca. Both are fixed just like that sew box. So cell wall is made up of silica. That's why, so it is not indestructible. Indestructible means it is not breakable. It is indestructible. Indestructible. Indestructible means what is the meaning? It's not break. Okay, so they are known as that diatoms. Okay, it means in diatoms, this cell is also known as frustule. It is an objective bit. Frustule. Cell is also known as that frustule. So they are golden algae, desmids. Generally, they are having the chlorophyll pigments. This chlorophyll pigment is known as that chlorophyll C. Chlorophyll C, that's why they are appear gold in color. Right, fresh water or marine, they are phytoplankton means they are passively move on water currents. So cell wall forms two thin overlap shells. Okay, so it means above that epitheca, below that hypotheca, both are okay fixed just like the sew box, and cell wall form okay. So silica layers. So cell wall forming that silica layers. That's why cell is indestructible. It means cell is not breakable. Okay. After that, when the diatoms left behind over billions of years in the habitat by the accumulation of silica material over billions of years to form that in the habitat. So earth, that is known as the diatomaceous earth. Diatomaceous earth or kaisilgar. Kaisilgar. Okay, so it means by the over billion diatoms left behind that, so over billions of years, this diatom cell wall material accumulated in the habitat to form that earth, that is known as a diatomaceous earth. So that is known as that kaisilgar. So this diatomaceous earth or kaisilgar, so it is that gritty. Gritty means it is the roughness. Being gritty. Gritty means it is a rough and it is a porous. Porous. Due to the presence of roughness, so they are used for that polishing. Okay, polishing the metals or ornaments. And the porous. Due to the presence of porous means they having the small pores or small holes. So that's why it is used for that filtration of liquids. It means oils and syrups, right? So that is the use of diatomaceous earth, right? After then, diatoms showing of that symmetry. So it means based on symmetry, they are divided into two types. Radial symmetry, second one is bilateral symmetry. So radial symmetry means, for example, which diatom is divided into, okay, it's showing of that, so it is known as the radial symmetry. So which diatoms are showing radial symmetry, they are known as that marine. Marine means they are grown in ocean region or sea region. So which diatom showing of that bilateral symmetry, they are known as that pinnails. So which showing of the radial symmetry, they are known grown in marine and ocean, they are known as the centrales. Centrales diatoms and pinnails diatoms. So they are known as the fresh water. Right? Asexual reproduction takes place by that fission. And sexual reproduction is takes place by that fission of gametes. Okay, so at the time of sexual reproduction, they producing asexual reproduction, producing sexual spores. They are known as rejuvenatory spores. They are also known as oxospores. If at the time of sexual reproduction any part is lost from the diatom, again they are regained by the formation of oxospores. They are also known as rejuvenatory spores. They are known as that sexual spores. So they are known as the diatoms. After the diatoms, so what is the next one? Dinoflagellate. Dinoflagellate, generally they are grown in that mostly marine. So they are appear in the different colors. It means red, blue, yellow, green, brown. Okay, different colors. So depend upon the presence of chlorophyll. Depend upon the presence of chlorophyll pigment, they are appear in different color. Right, cell wall having that so thick stiff cellulose plates. So stiff cellulose plates are present in that so these are the stiff cellulose plates. Present on cell wall. Right? So between that stiff cellulose present in furrow, so two types of flagella are formed. Okay? So one flagella is longitudinal Another flagella is horizontal. Horizontal. One flagella is a longitudinal, another flagella is a horizontal. So these two types of flagella so is helpful for that spinning of moments. So that is known as that whirling whips. Whirling whips, they showing off the spinning moments. Right? Dyno means two. It means two flagellas are present. That's why they are known as that. One is a longitudinal, one is that horizontal. They are present in the furrow of stiff cellulose plates. Okay? So in the dinoflagellate, generally at the time of interface, chromosomes condense. Condense and only DNA without histone proteins. So without histone proteins, so chromosomes are condensed and only DNA without histone proteins in at interface. At interface, that is known as the mesokaryon. It is an important bit, objective bit. In dinoflagellate, chromosomes are condensed. It means only DNA is present without histone proteins. At interface is known as that mesokaryon. Right? For example, in some dinoflagellate, for example, what is the meaning? Noctiluca. Noctiluca showing of that bioluminescence. Bioluminescence means what is the meaning? It produces light at the time of night by the presence of protein. So that is known as that bioluminescence. That is known as the noctiluca. Okay. After then, goniolocks. Goniolocks, by the rapid multiplication in that Mediterranean Sea, that's why it is red tides in Mediterranean Sea. Red Sea appear in red in color. Okay? So Noctiluca showing off bioluminescence. Bioluminescence means it produces light. At the time of night, so by the presence of protein, that is known as the Noctiluca. It is also known as, so it means bioluminescence. Goniolocks, it is a fire algae. By that rapid multiplication, by the cell division, it produces a number of cells. So the cells are float on the surface of water just like tides waves, appear red in color. So that is the red tides in Mediterranean Sea by the presence of goniolocks. And it producing of some dinoflagellate producing taxins. They are producing taxins. By the producing of the taxins, so it is cause for the death of fishes. Taxins released by some dinoflagellate. It is cause for death of fishes. Okay? So they are known as that dinoflagellate. Okay? After that,